Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Tabitha. If you're new to this channel, welcome and please subscribe. Today we are going to talk about how to save on taxes for individuals who only have employment income and no side business or investment income. How individuals save on taxes. But before we do that, we have to define what tax is. So tax is something that every individual is familiar with in North America because we all pay it. But what it is? So tax is a compulsory contribution that the government levied on workers' income, business income on profit or on the cost of some good and services and transaction. So we have to contribute this amount to state revenue. But individuals have choices of not paying this tax legally or reducing the amount of taxes that they pay every year legally. So, but why do we pay taxes? We pay taxes so we can build, the government can build infrastructures like roads, bridges, pay services, public services like hospitals, school, and paying a police, or doing a lot of things in the community. That's the reason why the government levy tax. There are different tax advantage ways in which individuals can reduce the amount of tax they pay to the government. You can keep a complete record. Keeping a complete record is keeping your receipts, and it could be rental receipt, it could be a business receipt. And then when it's time for you to file tax, and then you can present them. Because even if you file your tax and you don't have those receipts, and the CRA will follow up, and if you don't provide those receipts, they will really take back the tax return that they had. They will recalculate the amount of tax return that they were supposed to pay you, or maybe recalculate the amount of the tax that they were supposed to that you were supposed to pay the government. So it's something important. Keep your receipt, and if you have to claim this amount of money that you have in your receipt, and then you have to be able to present those receipts to the CRA. File your tax on time, because if you file your tax late, you'll have to pay tax filing penalties to the government, and this will reduce the amount of the tax return that you get back from the government. You can hire a family member to file your tax. This can reduce the amount of the fees that you pay, or some family members who are expert in doing taxes, they can really do it for free for you. So it means you'll save on the amount of money that you get back from the government and use it to do some other things. Tax deduction. There are a lot of tax deduction, and individuals who have employment income, they are eligible of contributing $5,000 or $6,000 to the RSP every year, and this will reduce the amount of tax liabilities that they have to pay to the government. So in this case, higher income earners save more on tax because their tax marginal tax is higher, the rate that they are supposed to pay. So let's say, for example, if you were earning 44,000 a year and you contribute 5,000 that year, you will only be taxed on 39,000 and you will save on taxes, which means you will get more tax return from the government instead. Other tax deduction that we have, there are charitable donations. So if individuals donate to these companies, they can keep their receipt and show it to their tax accountant when they are filing their tax, and they will be given back the credit. We have employment expenses. So if you buy some requirements, things like uniform, shoes, gloves with your own money, and the company do not reimburse the amount, and then you can keep your receipt and show it to your tax accountant and they can deduct it from your employment income. Meaning you will be given back the credit and as tax credit. We have rent up to 6 months. Maybe this is only for people who had employment income, and for those who do business, it could be for you claim the whole year. Union membership or union due or membership due. So this are the fee that you pay to be part of the union. And if you pay that amount and then tell your accountant to deduct that amount before they calculate your tax and the amount that you will pay to the government and amount that they can give it back to you as tax return. Child support, if you get child support is not employment income. So it has to be deducted from your employment. So it's like tax deduction. It's already taxed from that person who was like sending it to you. It's the after tax amount. So it's not supposed to be taxed twice. So it has to be deducted from your employment and from your income before they do taxes. It's not part of your employment income. Childcare expenses. If you pay childcare expenses, then you have to present your receipt and how many months you pay, and then they will give you back tax return or tax credit. The tax credits that are available to low income earners, disability tax credit. We also have tuition. You can present your tuition, how much you pay, and you get some credit, tax credit. And you can also claim your interest, the interest you pay on student loans if you are among the low income earners who have a student loan. So you claim your interest. So this makes student loan to be a good debt. You can claim the interest that you pay. GST and HST, they are credit given to low income earners. If you earn more income, unfortunately, the government will not give you the GST and HST credit. And the first time home buyers get the credit, because I think they're also low income earners. Because if you only pay 5%, or maybe with the help of 5% incentive from the government. So this is the end of the video.